we're sitting here in Algeria, on a very sunny day. My name is Eldridge Cleaver.
Timothy Leary.
Michael Canis.
And we're discussing the drug culture and the American Revolution. I'm a fugitive, you're a fugitive. Many of our friends and comrades inside the United States are fugitives. Now, these people who are walking around seeking freedom and liberation through drugs, I think they are illusionary allies, that they're not really helping us. Merely by being there, merely by donning the guise of revolutionaries, by participating in the youth culture and the drug culture, I don't think that anymore, I don't think it's helpful to us. I think that the actions, say, of the weathermen, the actions that the Black Panther Party have been involved in, the actions of other revolutionaries that are not part of any organization, is what the present situation calls for, that kind of direct physical action aimed at physically destroying the apparatus of oppression.
I think that it's a mistake for we sitting here in Algeria to be making pronouncements about what's happening in the United States in a general way beyond this statement that the revolution is ongoing, this is a crucial period, there is not time to tarry. The taking of any drug which were postponed for 10 minutes, the revolution and the liberation of our comrades and our brothers and sisters in prison must be eliminated. There is no time for escape. The use of any drug which takes your mind away from the basic issue, which is liberation revolution, must be postponed.
Much of the drug culture in the United States for many years was focused on you. So, you were the spokesman for that. Priest.
Well, that's image.
Well, it's image. But that's
it's image. Image,
yeah, it's image. We're also dealing with images, you see. I think that you're being evasive when you try to characterize that as making general statements, you see.
Yeah, I'm being very specific about this one generalization, that any use of drugs is either going to help or hinder the revolution. Now, if someone were to come to me and say, hey, look, I have a chance to give LSD to 100 FBI agents, I would say, right up, because I know if 100 FBI agents took LSD, 30 of them would drop out of that plastic fascist bag immediately. So in that case, LSD could be seen as a revolutionary instrument.